Hey guys, I'm LB. We are back playing the Talos Principle community content. And we are here in 1-2-3 in the fourth dimension. And, I spent a long time between episodes just thinking about this. And what I came up with is that we have to have a way... We have to set things up so that when we step on this pressure plate, one of the laser connectors crosses the beams and interrupts it so that these alternate. And once I figured that out, I couldn't figure out how to do it, so I had to look at the walkthrough. And I paused as soon as I realized the piece of information I was missing. This actually uses two mechanics that are seldom used in puzzles, and that makes me really happy. So, let's get this started, first of all. So, what we want to do is we want to have it so that the jammer is pointed through this barrier to that one. So that, when the clone steps on the button, it turns this off and then it can turn that off. And that'll allow the laser beam to go to there and then cross the beam. So, we need to set that up real quick. No, that's fine. Hello, let me pick that up. That was bizarre. I've never seen that happen before. Alright. Not sure what happened there, but we'll work with it. Okay, so, this jammer is still actually pointed at that over there. It just can't deactivate it because this barrier in front of it is blocking the line of sight. So what we'd want to do, we'll set up this connector like normal. And now, this is where the magic happens. And this is what I could not figure out without looking at the walkthrough. So, let's see... We want to do... Like, if you look... That's exactly what we want to happen right there. Because we're gonna place the, we're gonna leave the clone connector right there. And we're going to place the real connector back in its cage. But it's gonna be- it's still gonna be connected to both things. And then it'll cross the beams whenever we step on the pressure plate. Okay, so first of all, record, we get over the wall. And we walk inside. And then we go in there, place it there, and then we come back. And then... we just do this a bunch. I don't know how many times to do it, I'm just gonna do it as many times as I feel like it. Yes! It's working. Almost there! Yes! We did it! We did it! Awesome, awesome, awesome. So now... Oh, I didn't even see this one. That must be, like, the first one. So now we have to do all these things if we want to get the star, and I'm still not entirely sure how to do that. But we can at least, you know, investigate, right? So, let's think about- oh yeah, there's keys still up there. I wonder why they look purple from a distance. So let's think, right? We could do the same thing I think we have to do the same thing to be able to flip all these while we're going back. And then we would have to do these in here, and then climb back over, and then come in here, and la 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 la. So not only will we have to go... Oh no, actually, we could just come back through this way, yeah. But... I'm still thinking about this. So we know we have to go along in this direction in that order, right? And then... Oh, come on. Once we get over here, that's 3, that's 4, and then... What about... Where would 5 be? Would this be 5? I'm assuming that that's 5, right? Looks like a symbol that would indicate 5, you know, like... Instead of a slash for tally mark, you know, and then that would be 6. Then we come back around here, wait. 5 plus 1, that's 5- where's 5 plus 2? Where is 5 plus 2? There it is! So we have to, once we've done this, we have to go and hit that one, and then come back into here again. And then do this one. Oh wait, what about... Maybe... Oh, maybe the end shape is a 10, not a 5. Cause there's 5 right there, and then 6. Then where would 7 be? Unless the N is 7? I am so confused. Is there a 7 in here? Oh yes, there's stuff in here. Okay. 4, 5, 6, 7... 8... 9. So the N is 10. Alright, alright. That's insane, let's go through this again. We start here, we go through all of those. Gets up to 4, and then... We have to get in here... to 5... 6... And we have to come back... actually, we would take this ladder right here... to get back after we've done 6. And then... We would come in here and do... 7, 8, 9, and then we do 10... 11... 12... And then we go back in there again... After we've done 12, and we hit up... 13... and 14. And I think 14's the last one, because I don't see a 15 anywhere. Would be pretty insane. It's already pretty insane. No, I guess 15 makes sense because this one over here is, yeah, this is 1, so this is- it's 16 total, this is just 0 right here. Holy crap, this is an intricate star. I think it's pretty simple, though, now that we know the solution to the puzzle. Let's think. So what we need to do first is get the connector back. Alright, so... We run in there... We run around... We get in here... We go get the connector back... We come back... And then we'll place it, and then we'll think about what to do next. I think, if we just record ourselves alternating for like a really long time, it'll give us plenty of time to do everything. I think. Oops, ammo. Let's think about this. Yeah, okay, so that's still set up the way we want it to be. Okay, so we have to go in there and get the connector set up, and then we climb back over and start here. Wow. Okay. Two. I'm gonna do a bit longer on and off, because I don't remember how long it takes for the laser thing to charge up. So we basically just have to do this for a good solid 2 minutes. Because I really do not want to have to do this again. I would rather do it a little bit too long than a little bit not enough. And we should be able to get everywhere just by me alternating like this. But I am gonna go all the way up to 2 minutes, because I really want to make sure that I have enough time to do all of this. Okay. Let's hope that's enough. Right, right, we need to start here first. That's one, that's zero, one, two... three... four, and then where was five, six, and then seven, eight, nine, and then 10, 11, 12. 13, 14. Well, nothing happens. I heard them reset, so clearly we have a limited amount of time to do all this, which sucks. Either that or I did something in the wrong order, but I really don't feel like it. What the heck? What the heck happened there? That was strange. I really do not know. Alright, well, let's go try and work on the other puzzle. do we get into here? Right, because of this thing. I forgot. Oh, wait a minute. This one is separated now? That's interesting and bright, because the colors aren't even correct. Right. I really hate, these macro puzzles. Exchange the colors. Oh, we gotta... I bet we have to put one of them on a wall so that it goes above. But here's the thing, we only have 4 connectors to work with. Which obviously is enough, or else the puzzle would have more. First things first, let's get that guy over to here. Is that fan... I didn't check, are these both permanently installed? That one's permanently installed, what about this one? That one looks like we can... okay. I didn't even... did not even wait long enough. I'm an idiot. So now we have both objects in here, right? I'm still confused about the fact that that connector is in there. I have an idea. We connect this guy to both, connect one of the connectors directly to the eagle, and then the other connect- well, no, because... no. I am thoroughly confused. I'm gonna have to do some more thinking between episodes, because this is just beyond me right now. Well guys, as always, thank you for watching. If you hate the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you, and I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye.